what's up? It's your girl Maserati Monty, and I'm here with the gifted, the blessed, talented Lonny Beryl. You know what I'm talking about?
Boom, boom, boom.
Don't hurt your head.
Boom, 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 boom.
You've earned a ASCAP award. Mm-hmm. You were nominated for several Grammys.
Oh, yeah.
And you just, that's just more than anybody has done. They've been on the grind for a long time.
Yeah.
You know, we got people out here that's been on the grind forever and have not yet to achieve that.
That's crazy.
Tell us, like, what is your ingredients in this success?
My ingredients.
Can you share with us?
My ingredients is just God and God and more God. Like, you know, you can't sit in the house and be depressed and just worried about what's not happening. You got to go get it. Like, sometimes, like, my first award was Please Don't Go, of course.
Right.
And I didn't have any studio sessions booked that day. I just was chilling, woke up. It's like, let me call Tank.
Right.
I call him. He's like, what you doing today? Man, I'm in the studio. I'm coming through. I didn't wait for him to invite me. I ain't wait for nobody to call me. I would get up and call people. I would get up and call Jamie Foxx. What you doing today?
Right.
And I'm over here. All right, I'm coming through. I'm not missing out. And so when I got to the studio that day with Tank, and he had already been working on Please Don't Go, he's like, listen to this. And I listened to it, and he said, you can go ahead and write whatever I didn't finish. And he walked out. I sat at the table, man, and got in the booth. Engineer recorded me. He stayed out the room. When I was done, he came back in, and he loved everything that I added to the song. And then he made a few small changes, but that was my first big record.
That's crazy. And when you and Tate collab, it's like peanut butter and jelly.
Yeah,
like,
yeah.
It just goes so good together.
Yeah, we went on to do my next big record with Tank.
Mm-hmm.
After Please Don't Go was Pleasure P Under.
Right.
And got some Grammy
nominations. Yes, you definitely did.
Please
2010.
Don't Go. Yeah, Please Don't Go got right. Grammy nominated as well. And went on from there. You know, from there, a lot of people would say Lonny Beryl can't do up-tempo songs. He does great mid-tempos and ballads. That's what he does. So I had to go prove people wrong, and I got with my little brother Chris Brown, and we went to Orlando and worked on the Graffiti album. And that was our second time working together because I was a part of his exclusive album as well.
Right.
On a song called Wanna Be that me and Tank also wrote.
Right.
And we did I Can Transform You.
And that was a major hit. Period.
Yeah,
like one of my
platinum.
Son's favorite.
Really?
He's still by me. Yes, of course.
My
definitely.
First platinum single. And so I said, well, okay. So people still want to say I can't do up tempos. So I went on to do a couple more records. And you know, I got the song Strip out now with Chris.
Yeah.
Me and him wrote. And then With the Bed was another one.
Oh my God. Just hits after hits, Lonny. You are truly heaven sent to the music game. Like,
yeah.
You were definitely a part of God's choir. Like, we could tell, you know, before you came here on earth and blessed us with your talent, like, we could tell that, like, you have great talent.
Yeah, he's really
period.
Blessed me, you know, even just all the other projects that weren't even singles, like Kerry Hilson and Keisha Cole.
Mm-hmm.
The different projects I've been a part of, Snoop Dogg, of course, Kelly Rowland, her second album, and this new one that's out now. I have a song called Keep It Between Us. She's getting ready to release a single, the video, too.
Mm-hmm.
And, you know, I've just been blessed. I've been
definitely.
Blessed to be in great company. And I actually, it was easier for me as a songwriter once Tank got me, you know, involved as a songwriter and people started taking me serious as a songwriter. I had always been on tour singing background for a lot of different people.
Mm-hmm.
So while I was at home in the studio working for months, by the time it's time to go on tour with whoever I was with, whether it was Jamie, Tank, Ruben Studdard, Kelly, Brandy, like Mario, different people that I sang with, I always had my CDs from being home and in the studio.
Right.
So I was like, yo, listen to this. I got this. I did this. And, you know, when you riding with them people for months, you ain't got no choice but to check it out. So
right.
I took full advantage of that.
That definitely. And you've developed another project of your own.
I have.
Yes, and it's called The Love Train.
The Love Train, yeah. I had a single that came out last year that did exceptionally well, and it's still rolling a little bit.
Still popping right now.
It's called Favor. And it's featuring Kelly Rowland. And the remix is out with Kelly Rowland and Chris Brown as well. And the video is out. So, you know, shout out to everybody that's been
shout
supporting.
Out to the video. The video is sexy. It's just, ooh, that song goes for me, okay? Like, all your songs make me get in a sexy mood, period. Like, you know, collaborating with people and writing with them, it takes, like, you know, a personal you know, getting personal with the person that you're writing with and collabing with. Like, how do you decide if they're the person you want to collab with? And, you know, because it's difficult to, you know, collab with somebody that's not really your same style.
The chemistry has to be right. And a lot of times I'm good with, when I sit and think of the different names, I'm a great judge of who I can go great with.
Right.
And just being in the game so long and working with so many different people, I learned what works for me. And so, you know, when I called Kelly, of course, everybody know me and Kelly been working for years.
Right.
And it goes all the way back to her first Simply Deep album, where I toured with her. And that was like, what, almost 10 years ago now.
Right, and that's still crazy,
yeah,
still.
And then on her second project, I wrote like 6 songs and I vocal produced her on maybe like 10. So we spent a lot of time together in the studio. Even on the road, when I was on the road with her, I would go with her to the different radio stations and photo shoots, video shoots. Like, I was never that background singer that just saw the artist on stage and we didn't hang out. Like,
right.
Everybody I've been on the road with, I always went with them to everything. So it kind of prepared me for what I have to do now. I already knew what I was stepping into just being with them and seeing all that.
Right. Is there anybody that you couldn't possibly see yourself ghostwriting with or working with, like, just because of their style?
That I couldn't?
Yeah. Is there anybody that's like, we don't really mesh like that?
I don't know. I think I found a great way to call an audible. You know what that means, mm-hmm. football terms.
Right.
I can adapt. And I know when to fall back. I know when to take over. Like, and everybody doesn't know how to do that, but I've learned how to do that. Just almost is the same thing as singing background and then having to step out and sing lead.
Mm-hmm.
And so it's the same kind of thing. You just got to know when to sit back and let that person go. Or you got to know when it's your turn.
Right. Okay. So you got it on lock. Okay, Lonnie.
I've done a lot of school for this.
You have. You in the game. Yeah. You feel me? You doing your thing. I see you all the time. I see you coming out at the club, you and Tank. Y'all was on Turned Up. You know, y'all vibe together very well.
Yeah,
I like the chemistry between
you. Man.
I know.
Yeah.
And that's awesome. You feel me? So I just want to hear more from you and Tank, because y'all, when y'all get together, we're sexy. Babies are coming.
We have a new song together, and I'm trying to get it out there. We'll see.
Right, but right now we're going to focus on the Love Train 2012. Everybody get ready for that. Can you tell us a little bit about the features on that and how did that come to be?
The features on that, of course, Kelly Rowland. We got Jado, who's Busta Rhymes' new
mm-hmm.
artist. He's super dope. He actually wrote a lot of the album with me. We got David Banner, Tank and Omarion, and I'm going to hold out on a few other features that I have that I'm going to release as remixes, like Busta Rhymes and K-Mac. And I have another song with John P. Key, Anthony Hamilton, Tyrese, Jamie Foxx, and Omarion, and myself. I'm going to put one more person on it, but I'm going to save that.
Wow, save that because, you know, y'all save the best for last, and we can't wait to hear that. So,
but the album is great. It's a baby-making classic blast from the past type album, one that you can let ride all the way through.
Right. Yeah. All your songs we could play all the way through. You know, my favorite song is the one you made long time ago, like 07 or something. I remember hearing it, but it's like water, water.
Wow.
You know?
I forgot about this.
Yeah, that song is one of my favorites. I used to play it over and over. Like, you know, I've been tuning into you for a long time.
Yeah, that's a long time.
You feel me? I'm 25 now. I was 19 then, and you feel me? You still on the move. You still on the grind, and we're right here toasting it up because
it's definitely been a journey. Like, it's definitely when you actually see your music make it out. I appreciate every artist. Like, knowing the journey that it takes now, it's so stressful sometimes, and a lot of people don't get it. You know, all they see is the music, they see the parties, they see us living nice, but it really takes hard work. And the politics can really kill you. You know, everybody don't want to see you win. And you got just the budgets and this and that. You know, sometimes we get limited. And it's not always everything that we wanted to give y'all. But, you know, we appreciate when just to see everybody happy with the music, everybody celebrating the music. And we're going to toast it up.
Yeah, toast it up. Definitely. This is Lonny Beryl, baby. Y'all stay tuned with him for the Love Train that's coming out 2012. He got videos, songs, you know, Grammys coming up.
Oh, yeah. I'm back at the Grammys this year.
Okay. Yeah. Well, who are we nominated with?
Chris Brown, With the Bed.
You see, he is nonstop. Fame he album. Is phenomenal, okay? You are extra gifted. You know, shout out to you. That's why we got toasted up. This is Lonny Beryl. He's got a Grammy nomination this year, 2012, as he has for the past 12,000 years he's been doing this. But you're going to see him go even further, you feel me? Because he's really pure and sincere, and you can hear it in his music, you feel me? And the people that he works with is just over-talented. And you're definitely blessed, and I'm definitely
Thank
honored
you.
To... You know, come here and toast it up with you.
Pleasure is mine. Yeah.
Thank you so much. And, yeah, follow him at Lonny's, LONNYS underscore world. You feel me? Follow him and at Lonny'sWorld.com. Check him out. And y'all stay updated with his work because this man is grinding. You feel me? He's on his grind.
Going hard.
And that's what we celebrate too. You feel me? All the time, you on your grind and using your time wisely. And he does that. And clearly, you seeing the fruits of his labor. You feel me? Them Grammys, baby. Need
Let's
that.
Let's
get them. Shout out to you, baby. Thank you so much, Lonny. You feel
Thank
me?
You.
Appreciate it. Toast it up. Y'all stay tuned.